I wanted to say how nervous I am about this publication. I don't know, maybe I'm making it a big thing when it's not really such a big thing, but this is my first book published by somebody else. Hey guys, it is still, well, it's technically Friday morning. It's 1:02 a.m. I just had an idea and I wanted to see it through. So, let me show you here. So you know these doodles that I did for Patreon? I had an idea for the $30 people tier. Please excuse me if I'm speaking really badly. It's really late. Anyway, I had an idea to make a little notebook out of the doodles. So what I did is I scanned them all. I edited them on Photoshop and made them all blue. So they look like that. And this is the layout of the little stationery pages. There's like blue dotted lines and then the doodles everywhere. And then I also added a bunch of really kind of cheesy quotes like, "No friendship is an accident." I wanted to make them funny, but at this point I just wanted to see how it looks. Maybe I'll change them. This one says, "Let's go on an adventure together." So I'm going to try and print this out tonight and see if I can fold it into a cute notebook. And then maybe I can go to Michael's and I can find a cute corner cutter rather than having it just rounded. That's my idea. Like cute little stationery notebook. Not a lot of pages, just a simple one. So I'm going to try and print it right now because I just finished it. I'm pretty sure I fucked up. Could work, but my pages are all jumbled. This is supposed to be flush right here. Here is the second attempt. Alright, this is actually not bad. I think the only fuck up I did is I did not put something at the last page, which I anticipated. It's fine. Yeah, and then the other thing is this is not flush, so I just have to shift the pages around, but it's looking pretty good. I just used really bad rough draft paper. I think the width of the lines is fine, and then I just have to shift some photos. So the blue is going to be darker, and I'm planning on doing like a pink version as well. And now I have to think about the cover for it. So it's a very small little sketchbook. It's not worth too much. It's just some printer paper, I think. Or I might use heavier paper, depending on how many are in that tier. I think I only have three, so I might use heavier paper. So yeah, I'm gonna cut the corners just for fun. I also stapled it, and it's looking pretty good. So yeah, it's very light, but we're going in the right direction. Okay, I'm gonna go to bed now, because I have to. It is Saturday, 4 o'clock p.m. I was just working on a comic the whole day, and I'm taking a break by hand embellishing these sketchbooks or little notebooks that I made yesterday. I didn't show you guys that because it was Friday and I was just dead. But I'm just putting little dots on them with my gel pen. I'm using a blue gel pen because it adds a little bit. I wanted to do it on the pattern itself, but I find that the gel pen adds that nice glitter, so I'll show you guys it when it's done. So I have to make 5 of these for my $30 Patreon tier. And I just made them up yesterday when I got back home from work because I was like, I wasn't feeling like making a comic or working on my comics. I was just so tired. I needed to do something totally different, so I did these. I did get a nasty paper cut though on my drawing hand too. I don't know if you can see that, but it's a huge one down here and it's kind of painful. Thankfully it didn't bleed too much, so, and I just and I don't have band-aids at home, so I just kind of closed it until it looked like it wasn't gonna open. So anyway, yeah, I was so exhausted on Friday, and I think I still am, just because I've been staying up late this whole week, I think, because my boyfriend he's on a business trip right now, so I just chilled with him like really late at night. We were just hanging out, so I'm trying to catch up on sleep this weekend, and then hopefully next week I'll be a bit more caught up with my sleep because I'm so tired. I'm gonna let that dry and I'm gonna work on this one. So this one has a lighter blue color. I actually picked up the covers at Michael's. So this one's lighter blue. I like the lighter blue version, but I ran out after I had done a bunch of trial and error. I just wasn't sure about the size of the pattern itself, but this is how it turned out. Yeah, and I think it's quite cute. So these are the inside pages. I'll try and show you them. And I hope my patrons write on this. Like, you don't have to, really. It's just, I had an idea in my head and I wanted to see if it would work, and this is what it turned out. I don't have the best paper. I wish I could get like more textured cream paper that's just cuter, but in terms of cost, I wanted to keep it low because for obvious reasons, yeah, I don't want to go overboard my budget for the Patreon tier because I'm getting enough profits. I have to balance my profits and my losses. But yeah, I thought the hand embellishments are going to be really cute with this gel pen, so that's what I'm doing. I am so out of it. I came home on Friday, didn't do much. I did go for my run, and I ran maybe 18 minutes with a break, so that was pretty good. I thought I wasn't going to be able to run because I was just so exhausted, but I really wanted to keep the streak alive. So tonight it's going to rain, so I'm going to run after that. Hopefully it doesn't rain at like 9:30 because that's when I want to go. But yeah, I woke up at around noon, I ate a bit of breakfast, and then I started working on my comic that I really need to finish because it's almost the end. Well, it's not the end of June, it's like mid-June, and mid-July, and I need to finish that comic. I decided to add 10 more pages, so I don't know why. I just did because I felt like I really wanted to, so I did, and I finished penciling those 10 pages, and I'm just taking a break in between before I start painting. And I want to go out and get some candy, but I don't know if it's worth getting candy. I mean, I could get in some steps. I'm just bored is the thing when I'm trying to like take a break between tasks. I am bored because I don't want to draw because I am taking a break from drawing and I just don't want to sit here and watch YouTube videos, nor do I want to take a nap. Actually, I might be able to. I don't want to take a nap because I'll just be tired. I'm just bored and I want to eat something, and what I want to eat is candy. I don't know what else to do while I'm taking my break. I want to do something productive is the thing, and I guess I could work on my other comic, but again, I don't want to draw. Such issues, right? What do you guys do when you are taking a break from drawing tasks? Do you read? You probably just watch YouTube videos like me, like what I'm doing. Anyway, I'll update you guys once I am back to comicking.
Draw your own conclusions as to its veracity.
To others, assigning them characters from the game whom they believed were soul bonded to them. They found success. Obstinately calling them by the name of the character she would assign them. She would proselytize.
It is about 9:10. I'm heading out for my run, and I think I might drop by the mall if it's still open just to like walk around and be with human beings because I've been inside all day. So I'm gonna do that. I can't bring the camera though because I will be running, and yeah, I'll check in with you guys later. It's now 11 o'clock. I just got back home. I ran outside for about maybe 20 minutes with a break, and then I went straight to Walmart because that was the only store that would be open then, just so I can just walk around. But when walking around, oh, also I went to Walmart because I was really craving bananas, so I got bananas. And I got this. It's a set of scissors that cut your edges in different shapes. You know, like when you had a kid and you had those zigzag scissors? This is what it is, but for scrapbooker. So it does these kinds of edges. I got it for $13. I was walking around for a long time because I had it in my arms and I was like, should I get it? Should I not get it? I ended up getting it because I could use it for books. I was gonna try it. Sorry if it shifts to dark and light. I was gonna try it on these notebooks I was doing. And the other thing I got was this. I actually have this on my Amazon cart right now, but I saw it at Walmart. I think the only difference, you know what, I'm not sure. The only difference I think is that the one on the Amazon cart has it's USB powered, But then I'd have to like work a way, a contraption to connect this to my computer because I'm planning on putting this on that wall. So I just got it, it's battery powered and it's pineapple shaped. This is exactly what I was looking at and I think it's the same brand too. So I got it, it was $13. So we'll give it a try. I don't know if I'm gonna install it tonight. We'll see. It is Sunday afternoon actually. I slept in until about 11 o'clock. Then I went to the farmer's market. I just grabbed a little bit of vegetables, just cucumbers and tomatoes for my salads because I have leftover lettuce and stuff. I don't know if I told you guys, but my boyfriend is away on a business trip, so I'm alone at home until Thursday when he comes back. I'm just going to be working on comics today and actually work. My boss sent me some tapes to work on because Monday we have a report due and he asked me if I could do some work over the weekend and I was like, yeah, okay. Because it's not intense, it's just some dictation, so I just type it all out. But I did hang up my string light. It looks kind of silly because the battery pack is up there and then that's how long it is. I think it looks fine. I actually like people who are on YouTube and they don't have the perfect setup. I think it's kind of cute. So let me show you when it's open, when it's on. It's actually better if I show you at night, but might as well. Let's try it. Yeah, so the second part about it is I have to get up on my stool to turn it on, but I think that's fine. We're not gonna have it on all day. Look at that, it's so cute. They are little pineapples. Yeah, so they're the exact same one that I saw on Amazon, and the reviews for this were pretty good. They're like, oh, it's a really durable light. It does require 3 AA batteries, which is a lot, so I'm not going to have it on all the time.
Because if you look, a lot of them to me look like they have green. Then all these bits in blue and just say, it's a map.
It's a map. When I lie down and look up at the sky at the clouds, I think, map. I do like that.
It is now about 3 p.m. I'm going to take a little bit of a break and prepare my lunches for this week, which is the same thing. So I had my leftover kale. Really good kale at the farmer's market, and I have to get another container. I don't know what I'm gonna eat for dinner because I have no protein in the house. I have eggs and bacon, but I don't want that for dinner. And I don't really have anything in the freezer that I can defrost. I might have to go out and get something for protein. I'm really bad at protein because I'm not really into pork. I'm not into chicken lately. I haven't really been craving chicken. I don't really like meat either. I wouldn't call myself like a vegetarian or a vegan or anything. Definitely not a vegan, but not a vegetarian because I still like eating meat sometimes. And I don't restrict myself if it's available, but I don't crave it. I only crave like tuna. It's the only protein I like. I'm gonna open the scissors. Here's scissors. Okay, this one is called Mini Pinking. Mini Pinking. Oh, very nice. This one is called the Heartbeat. It's okay. Kind of looks like boobies. This one is called the Victorian. Oh, I got a text. Oh, I like this one. It's nice. And this one is called Lightning. I also like this one when I saw it. Kind of also looks like waves. And the last one is the Arabian. I like the Arabian. Nice. My favorite one is the stamp and the Victorian, actually. I am now going to pack up this commission that I did for somebody who commissioned me. Thank you again. So you watched the vlog, so sorry for the delay. I really wanted to get everything in order for this package. I forgot I have to scan this in and put it on my portfolio before I send it. Okay, I'm gonna scan this. I am just editing my feet for my website. I'm not sure if I'm gonna display it on the website all together or separate. I might do all together. So it's just me cleaning up. By the way, somebody bought this piece. Dinner time. I think it's called dinner time. Wow, thank you so much, Zach, for buying this. I cannot believe I'm selling this girl, these girls. And I'm kind of like sad because that was quick. Usually pieces like this would like sell in like a couple months or a year, but I just posted this maybe a few weeks ago, I feel like, and it's just going away now and I feel so sad. But you are going to a nice new home, so hopefully Zach takes care of you. I don't know if they watch this vlogs or anything, but I'm so sad. I'm gonna scan it again just to make sure. I'm gonna make sure I have the scanned file. And then, yeah, gonna get packaged. Goodbye. All right, so I had to Frankenstein a little bit of the plastic covers I could. I could do it for something like this, but not for the feet because the feet one is just too long. But this works. I had to do three plastic sheets. Just because the size of this is a little bit odd, and I still don't have enough money in my budget to get actual plastic covers. Someday I will, but I just have to work with what I have. And then these are the extras, so I don't know if they watch this vlog, but here it's going to be spoiled if you watch this. So there's two prints in there, an original, two sticker sets, my sexy 2 and a 3, which I already mentioned. And I just have to tape it all together with the note. I'm using my doggy washi tape that I got in Korea and it's almost gone. I really like it. But I still have lots more, so it's okay. Just finished my dinner and I wanted to update you guys on the stolen flower. Still doing very well. It's wilting a little bit, but other than that, it looks pretty good. So, yeah, that's it. Good morning, it's Monday. I actually woke up early enough to make breakfast and have it this morning. So I am just having some bacon and eggs, and then I'm gonna run off to work. I think it's gonna be a busy day today, Monday. I might be coming home late, but we'll see. Hopefully not, so I can, you know, fit in some stuff that I wanna finish up. But yeah, my alarm is going off.
Stop. 2 beef patties, cheese, onion rings, bacon, buns, barbecue sauce, all pureed and whipped. And we've got 2 biscuits here just waiting to be buttered. Of course,
I have my lights on. I just finished breakfast. Now I'm gonna go after I eat this banana. Was I gonna say something? I've been getting quite a bit of comments saying that it's okay if I talk about running. So yesterday I ran. I didn't run for very long because I decided to go on a new route. Like I still did my 15 minutes. I was able to do 15 again nonstop, which is great. But the problem with my area is I'm quite in a bit of terrain that it's not straight. And I like running on straight, flat terrain when I want to do long distance. But it's hard to do that here around here because a lot of the places go uphill. So I ended up going to find a different route yesterday, and it was great until I got to the point where it was all uphill all the way back. So I was out for longer than I wanted to be, and I can't really do that during a work day because I don't want to be out for too late or get lost at night. What I did yesterday too is I ran by a trail that was close by, and I didn't want to run through. I would get home earlier if I ran through the trail back, but it was getting dark and I didn't want to get stuck in the woods in the dark, so I had to take the long way. But yeah, so during the weekdays, I can't really run very far because I have to get home in about, I do my runs in half an hour, and I don't want to be out for too long because again, I have to go to sleep and go to work. So anyway, I'm going to go to work now and I'll see you guys probably when I get back home. Oh yeah, I found this Fitbit. It's not a Fitbit, it's like a fake kind that I bought on Amazon for like $40 a while back. So I dug it up again and I used it yesterday to measure my running. I was able to do, I think I was able to do like almost a mile in running. I don't know how that is. I don't know if I like using it. I just like using my regular stopwatch because it's a lot easier to press when I'm done running and stuff. But I think I should get used to it because it also tells me apparently how much calories I lose and my heart rate and steps. So, plus I bought it, so I should use it, right?
Guys, I just got home. It is about 7 p.m. and there is a thunderstorm just about to begin. I don't know if you saw that lightning.
I don't know if I can catch some thunder.
Anyway, I was hoping to catch the thunderstorm before it started because last time when it stormed, it was a really heavy rain, and our apartment has some issues with the, what do you call it? Just where the, I forgot what they're called, where the rain falls through, the eavesdrop, the trough, I don't know how to pronounce that, but it floods it floods in the backyard. So I just want to watch it because it might happen again. I didn't vlog any of that because it was just it just happened so fast. What happened was the seal in the door didn't last, and there was a little hole where the water escaped, and it just all just poured through the kitchen area. So we had, my boyfriend and I just had towels, and like we were kind of mopping it up as it kept going because the storm lasted for about 20 to 25 minutes. So we were just like waiting and trying to not make the whole kitchen flood. So I'm here by myself, and I want to make sure it doesn't do that. I looked in the backyard to try and figure out what the problem was, but I don't know if I can fix it. My landlord did warn us that might happen and we should just watch it. Sometimes if there's too many leaves or something, but there were no leaves or anything that, because there's a drain out there. But the drain is not strong enough if the rain is extremely strong.
It's starting.
It's already leaking. Do you see this? That's just the beginning. Good thing I have my towels ready. Oh man, it's gonna be bad if it keeps going. I hope I don't jinx myself. I think the worst is over. I don't hear the rain, and I checked outside and it's no longer raining, so I'm just gonna leave this towel here and hope it holds. I didn't have to use my bucket, so that's good. Back to work. It's about 9:20. I'm gonna go out for my run, and hopefully when I get back home I'll catch that another thunderstorm. Apparently it's gonna rain again, so I'm gonna do it before it starts around 10 p.m. I have my keys latched onto my workout bra because I don't have any pockets. So, let's go. And I'm back. I tried to remember to write down how long I ran for on my agenda. So I think it was, I'm still getting used to this, so I don't know. I have to like estimate 15 minutes with break after 15 plus maybe 3 more minutes. So in total about 18 minutes. I had my shower, so now I'm just continuing on with my comic work. I'm just cleaning up all the scans, and then tomorrow hopefully I can lay out the text, and then later in the week I can print out a mock-out. I can print up a mock-up, so I know that all my spreads are going to be proper spreads, and I can add any pages that I need to make sure everything that I want to spread is a spread. It is 1 a.m. I should have stopped barking an hour or two ago and went to bed, but I felt like cutting stickers, so I printed out stickers for the $5 Patreon people. I really should get the packages started, because once I get them started, like I take out the envelopes and I put stuff in the envelopes, I get everything done. The only thing I'm getting worried about is finishing up that comic for the $30 tier, just because I'm running a week behind in schedule in terms of the comics.
And I really want this comic that I'm working on, the digital one, to be really good, so I might have to make... I'm thinking about making a little sketchbook. A sketchbook that has my sketches, not just like an empty sketchbook. So Joyce Sand sketches or something, because I rarely show sketches, just because I think it's not really... It doesn't really show much because my sketches are just so jumbled up, but I'm going to see what I have in my sketchbooks and I'm going to think about it. And then the other idea was to make, the original idea was to make a zine out of this. But again, I'm just like, that's not good enough. It has to be good for my Patreon people. So anyway, I'm going to do a little bit of thinking, but I have to go to bed because tomorrow I have work. And my parents have invited me to go to... a movie, the new The Rock movie where he's trying to like run away from a building or something, skyscraper or something. Anyway, my whole family's going, so I can't stream tomorrow again, and I've been trying to stream on Tuesdays, but it's okay. I might have to move it over to Wednesday. I have to tweet about that tomorrow, but I should go to bed. This is not good. I'm trying to switch back to a normal waking up schedule. Even if I go down to my 3 days a week, I still want to get up early. I should go to bed. Guys, so it is Thursday. It's not Thursday. It is Wednesday night. I just got back home from work, and I had to pick up a prescription from the doctor. So it's almost 8 o'clock, and my night is almost over. I got my copy of Canzine, not Canzine, the Broken Pencil magazine, which is just a magazine about zines, and they are the ones who host Canzine, which is a zine convention here in Toronto that happens every year. So in order for you to get a table, you have to register, you have to subscribe for a subscription magazine subscription from them. So I get these sometimes, I don't really know when, but I get them. I also received my pastels. And they are not broken, so I looked at this yesterday. Hey. None of them look like they're cracked, and they look perfect. So I was worried that they were going to be broken up, but they look great. And look how many colors there are. For $7, that's pretty good. Another thing that I wanted to mention is that my Cricut sticker or cutter machine is delayed. They delayed the shipment, so it's not going to come. It didn't come this week. It was supposed to come yesterday. It's now going to come around Monday next week, and I'm kind of disappointed about that, but it's okay. I was really hoping to get some, you know, practicing on that machine done on the weekend, but then I think about it, I'm actually going to be busy this weekend, and I won't be able to touch it this week because I have to finish up ShortBox. I haven't talked about ShortBox, so I'm going to talk about it now. I'm really tired, so it's really hard to talk today, but I wanted to really quickly talk to you guys about what ShortBox is, because I haven't talked about ShortBox since they contacted me back in May. So ShortBox is actually right now just run by one person, and that person is Zainab Akhtar, and she is the one who started this whole comics box. It's not a subscription box, so you don't sign up for it and you get a box of comics every month. She basically brings together a bunch of artists that she curates herself, that she picks, and then there's 5 comics in this box, a print and a candy that she chooses. And she started in 2016, and that's when I heard about it. And all the comics are indie comics, so small creators, but there's some creators on there that are big names, like Jeremy Cerezi did a comic for them, and also Sophia Foster-Dimino. Oh, it's so dark, I'm so sorry. But she is actually in the box with me. So Zainab picks 5 artists to create a new comic for her in this box, and then she puts it up on pre-orders on her store, and people can pre-order it, and how many people pre-order, that's how many boxes are gonna get made. It's crazy. When she contacted me back in May, I was extremely excited, and then TCAF happened. And TCAF, I actually got to meet her because she had a panel. And if you remember, in that TCAF vlog, I went to her panel and I listened to her talk about ShortBox. So she contacted me back in May, and I was extremely excited, and I was very... like, it was just like, what? Me? Really? So, of course I said yes. And so May, I had already started working on this comic. If you haven't went to the website yet, the comic is called The Island, and that's the other comic that I've been working on top of the Filipino comic, and that's the comic I keep saying I gotta work on this comic. But I never mentioned exactly what it was because I don't like it. It's not my preference when people are like, I'm doing something and then they never talk about it. I mean, I did that. I'm a hypocrite. But I didn't really like say what it was. It wasn't like the main focus of my vlogs. Like, oh, I'm working on this comic today that I cannot show you. I never said that. So anyway, I never talked about it because out of respect for Zainab and for Shortbox, I didn't wanna, you know, just... I wanted it to be a surprise because officially this is my first published comic. And I'm so happy that Shortbox is publishing it because it's like such an indie company, and it's great, and it's, I feel like I'm in the beginnings of it. It's, maybe it's gonna get bigger. Zainab was talking about how she might expand it into something bigger. She might buy rights from the artists instead of having rights to make books and stuff like that, because right now 100% of the rights are to the artists, so I can do whatever I want to this book. And that was another thing I wanted to mention. If I wasn't being published by Shortbox for this comic, I would have just shared it online for free, and I would have shared it. I would have printed it out myself and given copies to my people on Patreon on the $30 tier. But out of respect for Zainab and what she's doing, I don't want to offer The Island, which is my comic, to the Patreon people at this moment. Maybe I'll do it in the future once the dust settles on it and once all the short boxes go out. I just wanted to quickly mention that because I wanted to, just in terms of etiquette and respect for Zainab and how thankful I am that she contacted me, because it's really crazy. I haven't really wrapped my head around it. So, and like, I really want to talk about it now, even if I'm like extremely tired because of all the stuff that I did this week. So forgive me if I sound like I'm a lunatic right now and I can't form my sentences properly or I'm missing certain facts. It's because I'm very tired. I'm a week behind on this comic. It's due at the end of the month because in August, so July the 29th is the last day to pre-order your short box. So once that hits, I need to submit my comic by the 29th for it to be printed, and everything gets shipped at around September because the month of August is when everything is going to be put together and printed and all that kind of stuff. So I'm a week behind because I needed to make sure everything was like up to my, you know, expectations, and I can't even say the word right now. Everything was how I liked it because it's gonna be my first publication. And that's another thing I wanted to really talk about too is, oh my god, it's already 6 minutes I'm talking. I wanted to say how nervous I am about this publication. I don't know, maybe I'm making it a big thing when it's not really such a big thing, but this is my first book published by somebody else who is getting it from me and printing it out and distributing it to people that who don't follow my work. So I'm very nervous about that because all the comics I've done up to this point are, other than that one pager for Toronto Comics a few years ago, this is the first time something that I 100% made is going to a company, and it's not being made at home where I print it out myself and I cut it myself and I staple it myself. So I'm more nervous. I feel like, I don't know if the story is great because, like, you know me, I'm not the greatest writer, and I embarked on this goal to make comics every month or to make as much comics as I can to be more comfortable in writing. So I'm not 100% confident in my writing skills and not 100% confident on The Island. I feel like I'm overthinking it because I feel like the art on it is not... What if it's too much? What if people think I'm... Like I overdid it or something, or it's too much. Like, what if it's too extra? What if it's like that? So, I never usually have these thoughts on my comics because I just print them out myself. It's all me. But now somebody else who contacted me and said, I really like your work and I would like you to make a comic for me so I can distribute it to other people. It's only now that it's hitting me that it's like that. And I'm so nervous about it. I don't know why. Well, I know why, but you know what I'm saying. So yeah, that's what I've been working on for the past, I guess, month and a half. I'm almost done it. Tonight, this week is the last stretch for everything because I want to have at least a week before the final deadline just in case something goes wrong in terms of printing, because I'm laying the book out myself and I'm writing all the text out myself and everything. So it's a lot of work, and I don't know what else to say about it. I'm gonna stop talking, but the few more things that I want to say to end it off is, one, I'm very thankful for everybody who follows my work on YouTube, on Tapastic, on Twitter, on Instagram, everywhere, because without you looking at my stuff and, you know, just like interacting with me and telling me, oh, these are great, I'm reading these comics, you're giving me comments, good or bad, it's really so encouraging, because it keeps me going to making these comics, because there's some engagement in that, and that's what I like when I make art, is I want to engage with people and show them what I do, and they give me some reaction. So without you guys following me, I don't think I'd be able to make comics, really. Because why would I make comics for myself and not show anybody? So I'm just really thankful for you guys for following my stuff. And just thank you guys on Patreon. Thank you for people who watch my videos and stuff and read my comics on Tapastic, because it's really, I just really thank you. And I wanted to thank you, Zainab, as well for contacting me for ShortBox. Now I just feel like I'm so extra right now, but Zainab, really thank you. She probably doesn't watch these vlogs, but I just wanted to put it here and say thank you, because I feel like so lucky and so grateful, and I hope this begins this opens some doors for me in terms of making more comics. But I will still make comics regardless of the fact that they are going to get published or not. If ShortBox publishes it, and maybe in the next 10 years I don't get the chance to publish it, to get a publication again, it's fine. I'm still going to make comics because I just like making comics. Okay, I hope I didn't talk too much, and I know I talked like 8 minutes long or something, but I hope, I'm just kind of second-guessing everything that I'm saying because it's very personal right now. But yeah, okay, I'm done. Thank you. I'm gonna update you guys on the flower that I stole because I think it's dying. It is dry, but she's still going strong. I'm still gonna keep her there, like a nice dried flower. And I think today we're gonna switch this. So let's see what's on the back. See, they're double-sided too. I think I've already flipped this. I'll keep it. It's still really nice. So that is the new drawing from this New Yorker thing that I got. And the artist for this is Charles E. Martin. That is it for this talking segment about ShortBox. If you guys wanted to know more about ShortBox or want to see a preview of the comics that are going to be in that box, I will leave a link down below so you can check it out, and you can also see a preview page for my comic on that website. But yeah, check it out. I'll leave a link down below, and yeah, that's it. It's 10 o'clock. I got, I think, at least 2 hours in of work on my comic, on the ShortBox comic, but I'm in the final stages, so it's okay. I feel fine. I have to go run, though, because I couldn't run yesterday, so I feel like this vlog is not going to be, there's not going to be a lot of art in it.